Welcome DMV LAX fans to I Street and Buchanan Field here at Gonzaga College High School. For the game of the week, featuring the number 3 DMV ranked and number 23 nationally ranked Bullis Bulldogs versus the number 2 DMV ranked Gonzaga Eagles, who should enter the top 25 nationally with a win here tonight. I'm Cabo Maddox, announcing for our 6th DMV season for Varsity Boys Lacrosse media coverage and games of the week. Thanks for watching this Madlax Media live stream production. Joining me once again, providing expert analysis, is Matt Rienzo. Matt is a graduate of Gonzaga in 1993 and Georgetown University in 1997. He was a captain in All-WCAC at Gonzaga and a captain in All-American defenseman at Georgetown. Matt has coached at the D1 level, including 10 years at Georgetown University, in addition to 12 years as the Madlax DC Dogs head coach, one of the best club teams ever assembled. Thanks for joining me today, Matt.
Thanks, Cabell. Excited to be here. It's just a wonderful evening here on I Street. It's a great rematch of last year's thrilling win by Gonzaga. Bullis is definitely shorthanded, which I know you'll get into, without key midfielder and athlete Jewel Walker, who's in street clothes. So we'll see if Bullis can avenge last year's defeat. Going to be a fun night, Cabell.
Heck yeah. This is a special Wednesday night matchup. Rare Wednesday night matchup brings us marquee IAC versus WCAC contest that has produced incredible finishes in recent years. The Bulldogs will be hungry for a win following their tough loss to Landon last week, while Gonzaga looks to build on the momentum and confidence from their massive win over Georgetown Prep in the Jesuit Classic 2 weeks ago. This matchup went to OT last year with current Georgetown freshman and former Madlax DC Dog Jack Leland from Gonzaga scoring the game winner for the Purple Eagles. We expect a tightly contested affair once again this year, where at night, like this, it is a very tough place to play. You can expect the Eagles to utilize that home field advantage once again with that raucous crowd.
Yeah, I mean, you got all the acoustics bouncing off the buildings here in downtown D.C. We're surrounded by buildings in a very urban environment. It's loud. The student sections here, the stands are already packed. It's going to be fun.
This is a battle of two of the most consistently dominant programs in the DMV and in the country, loaded with over 20 college commitments. We expect
that's insane, Cabell.
Yeah, it's
20
a lot.
College commits on one game.
It's a lot. They both have about 11 or 12, and they're adding daily. We expect an extremely competitive, high level of lacrosse, smart coaching, and physical play. This amazing venue that you just referenced in the heart of downtown D.C., Gonzaga will bring in a large, huge crowd and should make for another absolute thriller game of the week once again. You can find the rosters, if you're watching on YouTube right now, in the description below and follow along. Let's get right to the Sport Automotive players to watch. For Gonzaga, Robbie Bath had the game-winning assist and was awarded MVP of the Jesuit Classic 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, Robbie's a very slippery, skilled player. He gets leverage, played a great game against Georgetown Prep, really solid all-around midfielder.
Freddie Fowler leads the team in points this year.
Fowler's a workhorse. Fowler's one of my favorites on the field here today because he just plays hard all the time.
Gaetano Sicatello,
definitely one of the best long sticks in the country in his class, headed to Yale, very talented, can do a little bit of everything.
And Michael Michalis, Mike assignment tonight.
Michael Michalis, yeah, I mean, he and Gaetano and Joe Matten, those three guys are going to have their hands full with the Bullis attack, who's extremely talented.
Yeah, we'll get to those guys right now. Jackson Marr, the aforementioned Bullis attackman, second leading point scorer, or actually he's the leading point scorer on the
42
team.
42 points, yeah, 22 goals, 20 assists. He's just a great athlete. He had a coming out party a couple years ago when I first saw him play, and he hasn't really let up. He's one of the better players in the area.
6'3", committed to UPenn. He is phenomenal. He is a load and tough matchup. We figured they're going to put Michalis on him, who's just as big. Then Thomas Petty. Thomas Petty is the St. Joe's commit, having a great season with 14 points so far. Braden Ferguson, the Syracuse commit, in goal. And Jewel Walker, he is a player to watch, but we were just informed he is not playing. He is a scratch, and that's a big loss. It's probably going to affect the point spread this evening, Matt.
Probably will. You know, he's a do-it-all middie. He does a lot between the lines for Bullis. He's a very good athlete. very good defensive midfielder, good on offense as well. So that's a big athletic loss for Bullis, and we'll see what kind of influence that has on their, you know, their enthusiasm and their overall play today.
Yeah, he brings a lot of energy and always makes an impact. All right, so for Gonzaga, starting on attack, Johnny Gardner, Freddie Fowler, and senior Charlie McNamara. At midfield, look for Robbie Bath, Devin Geary, who had the game-winning goal in historic fashion versus Georgetown Prep 2 weeks ago, and Ryan Rafferty, the high-scoring junior. At defense, look for Cicatello, Joe Matten, and Michalis. And then one of those two, Matten and Cicatello, will also be up on the wing quite a bit. Face-off specialist, Bobby McCarthy will take the majority of the draws, but look for Justin Weedy, the senior commit to RIT, to take a few draws as well. Goal, Kevin Kane is in the cage, who had a pretty good game 2 weeks ago. We'll see if he can continue that. On Bullis for attack, Jackson Marr, Quinn Anzalone, the Navy commit, second lean point scorer with 38 points. Jackson Tomac, the Michigan commit, nice player, slippery. Ike Silverman, 19 points as a midfielder, Matt. That's a high scoring midfielder. And he's uncommitted still. Jack Petty, St. Joe's, and Jack Mangan.
And we'll also look to see if Cooper Keel gets up on that first midfield today, see if he gets some run with that group.
They'll run their seconds for sure. Defense, Alex Latchford, the Bucknell commit. Blake Paris, who coach says is their best one-on-one matchup guy, who's committed to Tampa. And Braden Sewer, the Navy commit, will match up on Gardner and Fowler. Long stick middies will split between Ryder Hannon and Brennan Lane, the Bucknell commit.
Good long stick middie core here for Bullis.
Yeah, Fogo, Cooper Rebus, it's 73, a staggering percentage earlier. I think he might still be there. No, he's
going to be a good battle
67.
At the faceoff today, Cabell.
And Braden Ferguson. Yeah. Keys to victory. We'll get to those as their lineup.
I just wanted to quickly mention Braden Ferguson, great player. I got to coach him last summer in Placid. It's going to be a great matchup watching Kevin Kane on one end, big position player, and Braden Ferguson, a little smaller but very athletic and very quick reflexes as well.
All right, we'll get to the keys to victory as we go through the first quarter here. On the wing here for Gonzaga is 14, Sam Lukowski, so they're already changing up a little bit. They're going double poles. Look at that, Joe Matten on the wing. I call it hardcore. What do you call it when you put double poles on the wing?
Double poles on the wing, that's what I call it. And it's something that Gonzaga does all the time because they just want that extra athletic presence up there.
Picked up by Brennan Lane. He's got space. He's driving. Kicks it out to Quinn Anzalone here on the near side. Love this venue. We're about 20 feet from the field here. Such an easier call.
I wonder if Quinn's going to go to the goal right away. He's got a shorty on him because of the face-off alignment. Nah, they're switching. James Gardner's switching up top to a midi, and they got Joe Matten on Anzalone. I'd like to see them switch that quicker. You don't want to leave a shorty on Anzalone too long.
Gonzaga going with Eric Carey, the fantastic athletic sophomore varsity soccer player. Nice set play coming out of the books here, out of the blocks. Gives it to Fowler, over to Gardner's cousin. Bouncer, righty. He did that in the last game for the first goal of the game.
Yeah, you know, obviously Johnny Gardner's figured something out since last year. They're giving him his right hand. He's taking advantage of it, and it's the exact same shot. He scored two goals against Georgetown Prep last week. It's a bouncer to the top corner of the far pipe. It's literally a carbon copy of the two times he scored against Georgetown Prep.
And it's his right hand.
His incredible versatility by Johnny Gardner.
Yes. But a quick takeaway.
That was a hit by Joe Matten that was called a penalty. He must have had his hands a little wide to the point where they called cross-check because I didn't see a penalty otherwise. But Joe's going to spend a minute in the sin bin. So Bullis will have their first extra man opportunity here.
And we are sponsored by the Cookie Batch once again. Phenomenal sponsor for the hit of the game.
You love the Cookie Batch.
And you know what? We're not going to give it to an illegal hit. So we're looking for the cleanest, most physical play in this game tonight. 3-3. No, circle.
Bullis starting in an open.
Circle. Yeah, circle open set.
Now they cut someone inside.
Anzalone back to Tomac. In a 2-4 set, wide open inside. Shot off the pipe there by Ike Silverman.
That was a sneaky cut there by Ike. Nice. Just missed by an inch.
I always felt like the 2-4 set's nice. Now they're staying back into it, just different spots.
Yeah, they're just sending cutters again, and they're getting a lot of movement in and out, it looks like.
Wide open. I mean, he was left wide open there. Gonzaga couldn't rotate fast enough. Easy goal by Jackson Tomac off the assist by
Yeah, that was a little disorganized on man down there by Gonzaga. They didn't seem to be rotating crisply enough, and Bullis takes advantage. 1-1.
So 9 from 21 on an EMO goal to make it 1-1 here with 10:14 to go. I'm Cabo Maddox here with Matt Rienzo. Cooper Revis versus Bobby McCarthy. Two nuggets at the faceoff.
Two fire hydrants.
Yeah, especially McCarthy. Look at that. Look at that. And here he goes. He might get his first win if he can. Oh, that's a push. So McCarthy gets his first win. 2-1 in faceoffs. Pretty blatant push there. Unsure what the ref is slowing the game down for.
Gonzaga released out of the box before the whistle was blown. They have to stay in the box.
Cicatello up to Robbie Bath. First on midfield, getting their first action right now. Over to Geary.
We're more than 2 minutes into the game. It's the first midfield run for these guys.
Robbie Bath, the WNL commit. Senior, here's Geary, the South Carolina commit. Game-winning goal against Prep 2 weeks ago. Drives right on number 10, Grant Stevenson. A freshman playing defense here. He gets a step on him. Throws a shot easily picked up.
Bullis has a freshman and sophomore in their top two D-middy spots. That's something to watch today for sure.
Yeah, athletes. Here comes the number two, Ryder Hannon. Over to Zach Hammerschmidt. Dickinson commit. Picked up by Cicatello. He goes over the top to Robbie Bath. Robbie Bath pumps it down to Fowler. They got a 3-on-1.
They got a great chance.
Got to bury this one. And he drops it on the left side is Gardner.
That's the easiest goal he'll get all year.
He has got a short stick, though. He might go right back to the goal and score. And he gets a great save there by Ferguson. Braden Ferguson on a great save after Gardner had a short stick matched up for him. Gardner gets up slowly there. Did he get popped?
Yeah, he got popped, which happens on almost every dodge he does.
Yeah. Bullis sets up there clear. Hammerschmidt.
And here we start to see the beginnings of this tumultuous ride
here. Here's a 10-man. This is a 10-man. And this leads us into our next, what we should talk about, is the keys to victory. Bullis said, number one, Coach Balestri said, handling the Gonzaga 10-man ride. Here's Quinn Anselm. He gets a step on this guy. That's Matten. They handled the 10-man ride, and he said limit turnovers that lead to transition goals off that 10-man. Gonzaga's 10-man is ruthless.
Yeah, it's one of the best riding teams in the country, honestly.
Way outside shot by
Jack. They 10-man on almost every single ride, and it's very effective. Creates chaos in the middle of the field and leads to goals for them. I give that credit to them, to their ride for beating Georgetown Prep last week.
Tomac goes right by Michalis with impressive explosiveness.
It was also used a pick behind to create a little bit of separation. Really just a good, simple play. Bullis ran full speed, coming up past the goal line extended and shooting back across the body. Really just kind of a textbook.
I think Gonzaga has Michalis on the smaller, quick guy. They might consider putting Michalis on the bigger Mar. They have Cicatello on him, I know, but Michalis likes to be like bruiser, physical type defense. And that's kind of the way that Mar dodges.
Yeah, you know, it's a little discombobulated because you have the two poles up. So I think they're going to have to find their rhythm defensively.
Still a battle here in the faceoff X, and Cooper gets it. Cooper Revis up to Brennan Lane.
You got Anzalon with a short stick again because of the face-off configuration.
Yeah, but he's got a phenomenal short stick D-middy and James Gardner on him. James Gardner committed to Maryland as a short stick D-middy. Now the switch occurs. Matten picks up
Gonzaga Anzalon. At the start of the season had two of the top D-middies in the country, James Gardner and Ryan Pels. Ryan Pels, unfortunately, out for a while with an injury, so not playing today.
Here is Ike Silverman on Eric Carey. Eric Carey getting a lot of minutes here in this game. He did not play much against Prep. He is a fantastic athlete. Plays for us at Madlax and had two goals on the night.
Carey, 66, sophomore, getting a lot of run. Oof. At the D-middy position. Just on cue, blasts the pick, and then not defended well at all by Gonzaga. They didn't have anyone defending the picker who was ready to talk and communicate to Eric Carey there, who was defending the ball. They also didn't have anyone ready to switch if he got picked off. And so that's pretty simple lacrosse right there. A simple
defensively,
pick.
Defensively, yeah.
Lends itself to an easy offensive opportunity.
Not sure why they didn't see that pick coming. It was set for a while, and it was a pretty violent hit. Who's this going to? All right, Revis up 4-1 already early in the game here on McCarthy. Here is Grant Stevenson, a freshman, double teamed by two elite poles, and he splits them. The freshman splits them, gets a fast break, throws a smart possession bouncer. I mean, that kid's only a freshman. He's going to be a player. Here's a matchup.
This is a matchup for Anzalone, and he's going to want to try and take advantage of Matten waiting in the wings to double.
Mikey settles on him, just committed to Notre Dame yesterday. He's going to walk onto the lacrosse team. Here he is playing defense on Anzalone. Watch Settle's footwork here. He is a phenomenal defender. Ball comes out of the stick. Pop save, Kane. Second save on the day for Kane.
Do we have a trend of D.C. area D-middies going to Notre Dame and walking on? We had Connor from last year from St. John's. Connor Shanahan.
He's at Notre Dame now?
He's at Notre Dame,
And he made the squad.
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, Mikey Settles comes from a great family, amazing athlete, and phenomenal student. He got in on Notre Dame on his own merits, ladies and gentlemen. And here he is on the ball, on one of the best attackmen in the nation, the number 3 rated attackman in the nation. And why is Gonzaga not helping him? Why is Gonzaga not coming here defensively?
I would say you would want to slide
earlier than early.
As soon as he gets near the goal line extended, before he's above the goal line extended, you have an early slide call for that particular moment. You know, that's a mismatch from the beginning. No offense to Mikey Settles. He's a great D-middy, but you know, that's a top-notch attackman with great size.
And he's inverted. He's behind the goal where he's used to dodging, and Michael's not used to being behind there. And
you need a little bit of communication on defense. You need to go early. You need to double that.
4-1 Bullis early here. The crowd is dead quiet, and it was so loud in pregame we could barely talk, and now it's the quietest it's been. Was there after the man up? It was a late – what?
Oh, there was unsportsmanlike conduct on Bullis.
Oh, what number, 21?
Let's
see. 21's in there. So he said something after he scored, I guess.
It appears that occurred.
Yeah, we're going to assume that as former players. We know people get excited after they score. He must have said something. And now first man up for Gonzaga. Fowler down to McNamara's number 0. Down to 7, Geary.
Another open set. Bullis running an
Rafferty
open set last
there.
Time out.
Here's Fowler. Now the movement starts. Over to McNamara. Kicks it across down to Bath. Gardner to Rafferty. Rafferty looking. Johnny Gardner.
Good patience.
Didn't see much action there on a play. Geary should have thrown that back to Robbie. Robbie was wide open on the down pass. Oh, nice pickup.
That was a nice inside pass and a nice shot there by McNamara, but even better save by Braden Ferguson.
Braden seems like he's seeing the ball better than he did against Landon. We called the Landon game last week, and he has already got 3 saves and looks like he's on point. He made that save look easy. He got down quickly. Big overthrow. Huge overthrow. Matten's all over him. Oh, nice BTB.
What a play. Unbelievable. The no-look pass.
Oh, but he shoots the ball.
Good last-second recovery there by Michalis to get a check.
Yeah,
because without that check, that's a goal.
Irasari is now in for Gonzaga, and I thought that Tomac backed that up. But number two, Ryder Hannon with the BTB play. Ryder Hannon, the Ohio State commit, catches that with the long pole and goes BTB to Quinn Anzalone.
The penalty's released, so we're all even.
So they didn't tough throw. What a catch by Devin Geary.
Good hands.
That was smooth. So McNamara out to Fowler. Gonzaga kind of needs one here. I know it's early in the game.
They do
hate to use
one.
The word need, but it's 4-1 in the first with 4:40 to go. And they're bringing out their second line here with Hobson. Caleb Oliver, new second line middie. Gonzaga changing things up week to week here. Diving shot. He gets pushed from behind. Oh, no. They called in the crease. He got decked from behind. That's not the right call. That was Carter Caden, by the way, everybody. And then it's also Caleb Oliver on second line. First time we've called his name. Have to learn about him this evening. Wonder why. That's Hayden Wade. Son of our buddy Ryan Wade there. Sophomore getting some significant playing time, number 17.
That's right. Very good D-middy.
Yeah, he's good for sophomores. Oh, I mean,
he's looks like he's got his dad's girth.
He is. He's bigger. He's big. He's big boy. He might be bigger than Tucker.
His cousin, Tucker Wade, playing at Princeton, graduated from Bullis.
It's his brother.
Is it his brother?
Yeah, this is not Zach's kid. This is Ryan's kid. It's Ryan's second kid. Is it Zach's kid?
I think it's Zach's, but I could be wrong.
No, I think it's – I don't know. You might be right. We'll have to check back our stats on that. Somebody text us and let us know. We don't like to mess up family lineage. Although both Zach and Ryan are great guys.
No doubt. Great players, too.
Yeah, we all played with both of those guys. And look at McNamara hung up on a – first time you don't see many hang-ups in high school. And the crease is really low. Johnny's got to get higher. Here's Cody Hobson, a Merrimack football commit. Here's Johnny Gardner with number three, Blake Paris. I told you they were going to put him on
– That's right.
Blake's their matchup guy, Coach Balestri says. He thinks he's
– He can match feet. Yeah, probably the most mobile – athletic of the
10 seconds the on the shot clock here. You see Johnny go one-on-one. Johnny loves burying shots late in the shot clock. What a save by Ferguson.
That was a good save, but it wasn't a perfectly placed shot. It was kind of more into his body than Johnny Gardner probably wanted.
I'm telling you right now, Bullis looks way better than they did against Landon. And Gonzaga doesn't look like they've got it figured out at all defensively like they did against Prep. So Bullis in total command here in the first quarter.
Well, isn't that the way sports work, Cabell? One team coming off of a less than ideal situation, another one coming off big wins, and you've got that mental issue that happens when you've got teams that are on the upswing or the downswing, and they fight and claw back if they're on the downswing. And so this is what you get. That's why they play the game, right?
Totally, yeah. And it's an ICWCA matchup. It's number two versus number three. This is a high-level lacrosse. Gonzaga's not going away. We know Gonzaga is one of the toughest teams and will fight you till the end. They're at home here. The crowd's starting to make some noise for them. I hear the bass drum.
They got the drum out.
Bass drum is out, baby. Tom Petty, what D there by Eric Carey. And what a slide by Ciccatello. Eric Carey is a very good defender, coach, number 66. Did you see that?
He is. Good athlete. Strong.
He stepped in the crease. He actually stepped in the crease, but they're not going to call it. 7 seconds to go, and Quinn Anzalone's got to bury that versus the shorty. He keeps getting matched up off oddly. Shot clock violation. Kane makes a save anyways. Matten picks it up. Quick outlet to Sam Nestor, a D middie, and they clear it. But they're in trouble. He's got Ryder Hannon all over him. Look at Bullis's ride. Regular ride, too, by the way. Gardner goes to his right, kicks it to X.
Ryder Hannon, a good player, headed to Ohio State.
Chase Noyes is on attack now. Okay, he's on in for McNamara. So 25, Chase Noyes.
Chase Noyes having a good year with 13 points so far, 7 goals, 6 assists.
Chase Noyes is committed to Colgate.
Colgate's on a hot streak.
No, sorry, Fairfield. My bad, Fairfield. I thought it was Colgate. It's Fairfield for Noyes. And here is Gardner. Why do they keep getting a short stick on their back? Look at that quick double.
That's what you do.
By Bullis.
That's what you do.
Yeah.
When the best player is being guarded by a
shorty. Fowler's got a short stick. Are they in zone? Oh, they're in. Bullis is in zone, Matt. It took a little while to pick that up, but they're in zone. They got the shorty.
Yeah, we're not that
corner.
Smart. It's okay.
I like to pick that up faster, but they had shorties on the top corners, and they were in zone defense. So there's that. I hope Gonzaga knew they were in zone, more importantly, than we did. Because they were dodging the shorties.
Good coaching wrinkle by Balestri there.
Oh, Marr off the pipe with 4 seconds. 3-2-1. And that's the end of the first quarter. Pretty much dominated by Gonzaga.
The first couple minutes it looked like Gonzaga was going to dominate, but then tides turned quickly.
Let's get right to our sponsors. We have some phenomenal sponsors here again tonight. First, the Matten Companies. A special thanks to the Matten Companies for their sponsorship of this game. Where the director James and his three sons, who all attended Gonzaga, have competed. And Sheehy Automotive. It's easy at Sheehy. Since 1966, find the Mid-Atlantic's largest selection of vehicles. A special thanks to the Fowler family for their support of this DMV game of the week. And the Father McKenna Center, right here on campus. An anonymous donor has sponsored tonight's game on behalf of the Father McKenna Center in Washington, D.C. The Gonzaga community has a strong commitment to the McKenna Center, which serves men struggling with homelessness and families facing food insecurity.
I just love that. Thanks to that anonymous sponsor. That's very cool.
It's very cool. Their success depends on your support and community support. So if you can, please help by volunteering your time or donating at Father McKenna Center DMVLAX.org. And the Beltway Lacrosse League, built for the best, the DMV's top 18 and over summer league for men. They even have a Masters 35 and over league. Summer league registrations open soon on April 20th at BeltwayLacrosse.com.
Well, it's a great night here. It's about 70 degrees, perfect weather. Sun's starting to go down. Still have some light, but the lights are on here on I Street. And we got a great matchup. Should be a great second quarter.
Easily the best weather we've had for a game in a while.
Probably ever since we've called games together. Usually the weather's terrible.
Remember the weather here last year when we did the St.
John's game? Every game we've done together that's pouring and cold, and this is a nice change.
It was brutal, brutal. Oh, we've been informed. The Wades are cousins.
I told you.
Oh, you didn't know?
Yes, I did. I said they're cousins, and you said they're brothers.
Quick face-off by Cooper Rivas. I called it wrong last week, I guess, at the game, too. I don't know what I said. But regardless, they're both – the Wade family is a nice family, and he's a sophomore getting playing time. Zach's boy. Out comes – Ike Silverman, they'll play this first line 95% of the time. It's unlike Gonzaga or Landon that runs a second line and a third line. Bullis really just goes with one. Occasionally they'll get in Cooper Keel and in that second line of guys. They played once against Landon, one time last week.
If your middies can make it through the game, that's not a bad way, but sometimes they need a break per quarter. I like to get the seconds in there a little bit more than that.
Silverman back to Quinn Anzalone.
But if you have three elite middies, you definitely want to keep them out there as much as possible. Great save by Kevin Kane. I mean, not a hard save. It was thick side high, but still a good solid save.
Yeah, pretty easy save for Kane.
Let's see if Gonzaga can do anything in transition because they're not having much luck 6-on-6.
Robbie Bath gets through, gets to his left hand, pumps
it.
Oh,
there you go.
Off the pipe.
That was kind of the early offense that I was looking for.
Johnny, he's got to know those guys are behind him, and he tucks it just in time, gets by.
Oh, he gets vicious hit again.
Who dropped him? Three, Blake Paris, or was that? That was just a knockdown hit. He gets hit a lot.
Well, he dodges hard, and he does a kamikaze style of dodging, which lends himself to getting hit a bunch, unfortunately for him.
He'll learn.
But he's a tough kid.
He'll learn. You can't do that with the Maryland guys next year.
I don't know. I think he's going to play that way the rest of his life.
But you don't want to get hit by those 225-pounders that hard. Here we go. Geary and Fowler inverted. Nice pick by Geary. Throwback by Fowler. Geary has a shorty on him. Will he get the shot off? Solid senior out there, first line consistently. Here is Gardner.
Dodging from up top now. I like
nice
this.
Nice pick from Bath. Inside look. Push from behind there. No call. They get it. They call it. Okay, the top ref called it.
That was a loose ball push. That should be a second flag, right, Cabell? Flag's down.
You mean after the
Yeah, if they do a loose ball push, shouldn't that be a second flag?
Yeah, that's the newish rule.
Maybe they're not playing it.
Or no, maybe they play NCAAs. They should, but I think they're going to get a man-up situation here. Number two.
This is a big opportunity for Gonzaga. Conversely, let's see if Bullis can, you know, really hold their own and get a stop.
First one failed. Let's see if they can get a goal. Their first man up was not much, just a little bit of motion.
I really like that early offense by Bath on that last possession. I would like to see Gonzaga to keep doing that.
Yeah.
Before the defense gets settled.
Great save there again by Ferguson. That's his
sixth
save.
Ferguson's a great player.
He's having
a game tonight.
Look
forward to seeing him at Syracuse in the future.
That's dangerous for Gonzaga if Ferguson's on. Robbie Bath making a play in the open field. Picked up on the ride by Johnny Gardner. Nice play. Nice play. Were they offsides?
Bullis was offsides. Yeah, they called it. No, they
one,
were.
One, two, three.
They were. Jackson.
They still
Marge
only have five back.
Back.
Oh, they were man down, so that's right. They were offsides. Good call. They're going to get another 30 seconds here for man up. I counted quickly back, and I forgot they were man down, so they're going to be man up.
Yeah, Jackson Maher was riding and came over the line a little bit. I think he thought there were guys back so he could get back, but because they were man down, there was nobody back.
Got it. All right, here we go. Another man up, third for Gonzaga. His third time a charm. Ferguson, number five in the goal for Syracuse, is locked up tonight. He is seeing the ball.
Yeah, Ferguson has quick hands, good positioning, good technical skill. He's going to be a tough code to crack if he's on.
They just sent off Wade. I guess they're two man down for a little bit longer. The school.
Yeah, because they did. So they did.
No angle there for Rafferty.
Yeah, because they were two men down for a little bit of time, I guess.
Yeah, it's going to release
the other penalty
here,
was still.
3-3 set. Wide open down low. Goal. Bath from Fowler.
I missed it. I was looking at the box. The Bullis player released early, and the Gonzaga coaches were going crazy. The refs didn't call it. And then Gonzaga scored on this end. So
Robbie Bath was down right on a 3-3 set and got a nice skip pass from top center from Freddie Fowler, the Colgate commit, and leading point scorer on the team with 36 points. Call it 37 now. Here is Revis and McCarthy. Revis
just got a
up.
Text from Charlie Horning telling me that I was right on that loose ball push call.
Yeah.
Should have been a second flag. Thanks,
correct,
Charlie.
Yeah.
Will you text me next time they're in a zone so I can recognize that faster, please?
And then we'll text the Gonzaga coaches and tell them, too. All right, Gardner gets the ball down here, bringing out Carter Caden. This is the second line of Caden Hobson. And now they're bringing out J.M. Costa. J.M. Costa's nice sophomore. J.M. Costa down the alley. Invert, straight to the invert. With Caden and a double invert, two shorties behind. Here's JM. Looks comfortable back there. He is an attackman, converted right now to midfield. So
I like that offense, so I like inverting for Gonzaga, and I love the pick action behind, too.
Here they go. They got a single invert now. This is harder to defend, I always think.
Oh, yeah.
Great take.
That's a great play. Carter Caden, the Colgate commit. Really nice play.
Unassisted dodge in the invert on a single invert from behind by Carter Caden.
Gonzaga is featuring a lot more invert this year than last year and the previous years. I really like it. It's a great strategy. It's hard to defend. It puts defenses in really tough positions. You can feed from behind the goal to shooters who are open, or you can just run by and there's no slide sometimes. So really good job coaching from Gonzaga in that aspect.
Revis is dominating faceoffs. It's already 8-1. 8-1. But a quick turnover kind of negates all those wins. Michalis throws it away and trying to throw it to. What a save.
Incredible.
What an athletic play.
But it
Chase
went out of
Noyes
bounds
making a very athletic play there, the Fairfield commit. But then it popped out of bounds anyways. Back to Bullis. Man, Gonzaga had a turnover on the ride. Another turnover on the ride. Goalie out of the goal. And a goal!
What a wacky play. I don't know if anyone at home can even hear us. It's so loud here, but
it's
what
awesome.
A wacky play. And that's what Gonzaga does. Credit to their coaching staff for emphasizing the ride as much as they do, putting so much pressure on the clearing team. They've scored at least one or two goals in every game I've seen on the ride.
Well, we said they were going to get back. We knew they were tough. It was 4-1 after one, and now we are knotted at four with 7 minutes to go in the second quarter.
Just like that.
Yeah, but Revis oh, a nice pickup there on a check. I thought that was a perfectly good check.
Timeout call, Gonzaga. As soon as they got the ball in the box, they called timeout. Gonzaga will have a chance to set up something fresh here, see what they can come up with. What do you think, Cal? Will they go back to the invert? They go back to a big little? What do you think we're going to see here?
I think they stick with the invert, especially with the success they had just then.
Well, we'll see if Bullis comes out in his zone or if they play man-to-man. That will obviously have an impact on it.
I think sometimes Johnny Gardner and Fowler try to do too much. But
I like it when they start the ball in other people's hands
and then they give them
the opportunity to dodge and then move the ball up top. And then Johnny Gardner or Freddie Fowler are dodging off a re-dodge instead of starting the offense with all six guys looking at them ready to slide.
Thank you to our sponsors again here at Quantum Financial Advisors. QFA's five-star offense maximizes client returns while their five-star defense generates additional current income while mitigating market risk. Additionally, the Athlete Amplifier, QFA's new NIL, Name Image Likeness Initiative, empowers student athletes through personalized branding and sponsorship deals with local community businesses. Special thanks to our loyal DMVLAX supporter, co-founder, and Bullis parent, Joe Rinaldi. Learn more on both of those companies at QFAinc.com. And they're right back out. 4-4 here. I'm Cabo Maddox here with Matt Rienzo down here at beautiful Northwest Buchanan Field on the campus of Gonzaga College High School.
Cabo, you mentioned Joe Rinaldi. Do you know if his son Anthony Rinaldi is getting any burn up at Hofstra? Is he playing?
He said he's getting a little bit. Yeah, he's working
his
way up.
Great kid, great player.
Yeah. All right. Bullis comes out man-to-man. They rarely play zone. Coach Balestri's phenomenal coach for them. It just hasn't used a lot of zone over the years. Not showing any sort. Oh, we got a new wing dodge mirror.
Oh, my gosh. That was ridiculous. I didn't think that had a chance in hell of going in the goal.
Neither did I. That's four straight.
That was like Houdini stuff there. I don't know how he got the shot off. Never mind that it went in. He shot with his left hand to the inside defender all over him.
I don't think Braden saw it. I don't think the goalie saw it.
I honestly don't know how that went in. That was incredible.
It went in near pipe, and Braden didn't react.
Do we have an instant replay? Can we get an instant replay going?
Oh, yeah, I forgot to turn that on. We have the good fortune of doing, like, tape delay here. I can't even keep up with all of Rivas' wins, man. He's got 10, I think. 10-1. Just absolutely dominating, but it doesn't seem to matter. Gonzaga is still winning despite being down 1-10 in faceoffs.
Well, you know, the last two or three faceoffs they've scrapped and gotten it back. So it hasn't had as much of an impact in this quarter as it may seem. All right, let's see if Bullis can settle in a little bit. Yeah, that goes against the keys to the game. That was an early shot.
And look at this fast break with Gardner running the show. Pumps it down to Fowler. Fowler skipped down to Gardner. Gardner buries it. You know they were going to finish that one.
That was an incredible hustle play by James Gardner. He must have created an additional 5 yards of space when he started the run. We're watching it on the replay.
Oh my gosh,
he opened up and created an extra 5 yards. Our camera guy couldn't even keep up. Sorry about that. But Johnny Gardner, nice goal. And it's 6-4 Gonzaga.
Yeah. Apologize that. The player's running so fast, cameraman can't even keep up. What a ground ball there by Matten. Joe Matten over to Michalis. Michael Michalis, the St. Joseph's commit. Over back to Matten, to Kane on the clear. Gonzaga has regained momentum, up 6-4 with 5:38 to go. Uh-oh, throw to a pole in the middle of the field. Not the wisest play. He's in trouble, but he somehow eludes the checks.
Timeout call. Timeout, yeah. Pretty smart.
Probably a very
decent,
smart
decent
timeout.
Decent play by Jake Gullerson there, number 72 for Gonzaga.
A sophomore.
New to the team this year, and he impressed me actually in the Georgetown prep game. I didn't know much about him, and I saw him make a couple nice plays in that game.
Let's talk about the Surfside official post-game party. Surfside in Northwest, you're looking for the perfect post-game hangout spot. Look no further than Surfside in Tenleytown. With their comfortable outdoor seating, multiple TVs, and free parking, you can enjoy the best Mexican in town while relaxing after the game. We will see you there. I went there after the game last time. It was packed.
How was it?
Packed.
That was the NCAA tournament night, right?
Yeah. And Surfside owner and supporter and friend, Bo Blair, Georgetown Prep 89, we thank him for his support of DMVLAX. Hey, if you tell him, beat Landon, you may get a free margarita at Surfside.
If you're 21.
They're strict there. And the Sport Automotive sponsors the Players to Watch. Players to Watch is brought to you by Sport Automotive, Chevrolet, Cadillac, and Honda. Be a sport fan, too, and visit sportautomotive.com. You can see there on your screen the Players to Watch. There's one scratch, though, for Bullis, the last person listed there, Jewel Walker. He is not playing tonight. It didn't seem to affect Bullis early, but it seems to now.
Yeah, this game is got ebbs and flows in it. First quarter belonged to Bullis. Second quarter, Gonzaga. Gonzaga has the momentum here now. If they score, you know, this is the third quarter is going to belong to Gonzaga as well. So we'll see what happens on this possession. This is a big possession for Bullis. They got to get a stop here.
Oh, nice move. Set piece out of a 1-4-1 set. Pass down, pick down. Gardner gets his hands free. He's going to bury this, folks. Oh, deflected. That good. Is his favorite shot.
Good stick check there by number 90, Brennan Lane, on Brennan Johnny Lane. Gardner.
Brennan Lane's got some nice size. He's going to Bucknell to play for Coach Federaca, who likes the big boys.
He does like the big, rangy defenseman.
They have to play football usually like he did at Hobart. Two-sport athletes he prefers. Nice, another pick there by the short six. So they're coming out and doing high corner picks now two times in a row. New offensive look. This is the second or third offense we've seen from Gonzaga. Geary's got a one-on-one. Great move by Geary. Hayden Wade was on him, and he got his hands free and just uncorked one. It was deflected as well. Shot clock violation, 6-4 Eagles, 4:34 to go. I'm Cabo Maddox here with Matt Rienzo. Reese Belcher, our expert videographer, is on site. You can expect photos, videos, and more from him for the next couple of days coming out on this game. Here is 18, Ike Silberman. Gets a short stick, Eric Carey, the sophomore. Eric Carey, just as quick as he is, guards him fairly easily. Here's Jackson Marr with Ciccatello still on him. Misses it, lefty offhanded shot. But Marr showed the other night he has a left, and his left is almost as equal to his right. He is not one-handed anymore. Great blow up by James Gardner there. He jumped it, shot. Looks like he just missed it wide there. That was Quinn Anzalone on the shot, the Navy commit.
Jackson Meyer's impressive. I look for him to kind of make his presence felt here in order for Bullis to kind of regain control. If they want to get back in position A here, Jackson Maher is going to have to really step up, which I think he's capable and will.
Look at this young athlete. Carey down to Gardner. Gardner down to his cousin, Johnny Gardner.
Are you sure they're not brothers?
Yeah, I'm positive. Positive they're cousins. Uh-oh, dropped by Carey. Not sure why they weren't subbing, and a great pickup there. They don't have any more timeouts, though. I think they've used both.
They did.
And now they've lost the ball here. Wait, what's going on? Did the ball go out of bounds?
Offsides.
Oh, there was a flag down. Offsides on Bullis. Man, a little bit surprising there. This is the fourth man up. One was a goal. This is the fourth opportunity here. 6-4. What a game of runs. Gonzaga has scored five straight after Bullis scored four straight.
Gonzaga scored the first one, then Bullis rattled off four, then five for Gonzaga.
BTB pass. Oh, great.
Phenomenal save by Braden Ferguson. He got that with his glove hand. He just punched it.
Six on the day for Ferguson already. Fowler from deep. Nope. Johnny Gardner. Johnny Gardner probably had that going 95 miles an hour.
Should try and shoot it harder next time.
Missed it by 3 or 4 feet.
I'd like him to shoot that overhand, but he loves shooting a little sidearm three-quarter. And he's good at it, too.
There are 3-3. Here's a cut down from the middle. Gardner carrying across the top. Wants it. Kickback. McNamara, one more. Inside look. BTB. How does Braden see that so well?
I mean, it was right in his stick. It was not a well-executed shot. It was a fine time to take the shot, but just not good placement in his stick.
Grant Stevenson, the freshman here, looking to leg it out. Playing like a senior. That was deflected by Gonzaga. If that goes out of bounds. Where's the ball? Yeah, stays Bullis. All right, 2:26 to go here, 6-4. See if Bullis gets
a timeout.
It's a
big possession for Bullis. Cabell, I meant to say on the last goal by Gonzaga, Bullis had a really short possession. Jackson Maher took an early shot, and that was one of the keys to the game that Balestri had talked about, not wanting to shoot early in a possession. And they came down, and Gonzaga scored. So let's see if they have a little more patience and can get a great shot, not a good shot.
Jackson Maher here. They're going to get a timeout. They have two, so I was...
Balestri's going to set up some sort of set play here.
He's very good at that. He's one of the best coaches in the area.
Excellent.
He always gets a lot out of his team. They've won three IAC championships since 2018, which I think is the most in the IAC. I think Prep is second. Landon is in first place in the IAC this year. Gonzaga, they haven't started WCAC play, really. Gonzaga hasn't had a heavyweight match, let's call it, versus St. John's or Paul the Sixth, and now this year Good Counsel is in the mix. Let's look at the top 20 DMV rankings this week. Discuss those teams every Monday.
Seems like the top spot's been a revolving door.
Yeah, it has. But Landon gets it for the first time since 2017, the number one team in the area. Gonzaga bumped up from 3-2 with their win over Prep.
I will say I like Landon's team. They're gritty. They're tough. They're athletic. I've watched them play a couple times. They're well positioned to have a great year.
Yeah, they're prime with 14 seniors. Georgetown Prep at 4. Good Counsel is the biggest surprise of the year. 9-1 out of nowhere with Dane's coach bringing in a lot of good athletes.
Yeah, 4-5. I think you haven't seen the last of Georgetown Prep. I think they're going to rear their head back up.
Yeah, they got Landon on Friday. They can beat Landon on Friday.
And then Good Counsel is up and comer, to be sure.
All right, here we go. I have a timeout. Here is Ike Silberman dodging against Nestor. Nestor, solid footwork. Underhand shot. Save Kane. Picked up again. Shot, save Kane again. Two saves there by Kane off shots by Ike Silberman. .120 to go here. James Gardner with the ball. They don't have any timeouts. That's unofficially 5 for Kane on the night with stops.
Second line midfield, Caleb I, Oliver, Cody Hobson.
Interesting coach with in the last possession of the half is going right with the seconds. They run their 1-2s fairly evenly.
I would definitely put my first middies back in at the end of the quarter. You have a whole half to rest.
Yeah.
But They'll probably score and show me what I know.
Good hard dodge there by 36, J.M. Costa. It looks like J.M. is either inverted again or he's on attack. Here's Fowler. Fowler dumps it behind. Inside look to J.M. Costa.
Oh,
that was
phenomenal.
I told
you I didn't know what I was talking about, Cabell.
Wow.
That's a great look inside and a great finish by second line midi, J.M. Costa. And he forces me to put my foot in my mouth.
Who fed him? That feed was incredible.
I couldn't see from this angle.
I'll get it here on the I think it was Johnny Gardner with his offhand.
Yeah, Johnny Gardner right-handed.
Yeah. No, it wasn't. No, it wasn't. It was not Johnny Gardner. We'll get that. Someone was at X inverted. Revis, they have
a timeout. I'm taking a look at the replay again.
Revis. Just tough with his 11th win of the night. And a quick timeout there by Bullis with 31 seconds to go, down 7-4 here at half. Bullis hasn't scored since the first quarter. Gonzaga has all the goals, all six, and is absolutely dominating this quarter. It's 7-4. Did you get the number on that assist?
I couldn't see it. It happened too fast and was hidden behind other players.
Great assist there by one of their middies. I think it was one of their middies inverted. But we can look back later.
It may have been Fowler.
It was someone pretty big. I thought it was Gardner. But regardless.
Charlie Horning, text me who scored, will you please?
No, assisted.
Who assisted?
We know J.M. Costa had the goal, the sophomore. Great inside look from that player. It was a tic-tac-toe. It was 1-2-3.
Good ball movement.
Fantastic.
Gonzaga's looking crisp on offense. Moving the ball well, finding people inside.
One of our sponsors is the DMVLAX Showcase, a new event that will be held on June 18th. It's going to be for the top 24 to 27 players in the area, the best of the best, a showcase game. The seniors are going to play for free. More at dmblacrosse.com. And here we are back 25 seconds ago. Ball is live. Man.
Yeah, so they went with a simple pick.
Right by his guy off a pick, and I think, was it a save or a pipe?
Tough to tell from this angle.
And they're going to get it back. 12 seconds to go. Plenty of time for Marr. Should we give another save to Kane on that? I mean, that was.
You're pretty liberal with your saves, so go ahead.
I love stats. That was a heck of a play off the timeout. Got him a quality shot. There's plenty of time here. He gets another pick. Sprinting right. Marr, he is fast. Missed by a lot. 6 seconds. Still enough time for someone to go to the goal here. Down 7-4. Gonzaga wants to hold him. Bullis needs one. Got to go right to the rack. Inside is wide open. What a save by Kane on the BTB by Quinn Anzalone. That is Kane's seventh save, and he had a great first half. Excellent second quarter, actually. Wow.
That was a nice look by Anzalone, too. Lefty behind the back. Decent shot, especially with no time on the clock.
Let's review stats here at halftime first, which is shocking. It's a game of runs, and it's part of the reason why we love lacrosse. We love the DMV. But, man, Bullis was up 4-1 after the first quarter and scored four straight, and Gonzaga looked lost. We mentioned that Gonzaga was going to fight. They're tough. They're going to come back. But, man, they did more than that. Six straight goals.
You know, they showed some resilience against Georgetown Prep that I'm not sure we saw the last couple of years, offensively especially, and it's carried forward to this game. They're playing very well.
Goals by Carter Caden, Robbie Bath, Freddie Fowler, two by Gardner, and then the last one there by J.M. Costa. Let's go to our sponsors here and thank our sponsors here at halftime. Beltway Lacrosse League, the DMV's top 18 and over summer league for men. They even have a Masters 35 and over league. Summer league registration starts April 20th.
Who runs that league, Cal?
Beltway Lacrosse. Rich Hodge. Thanks to Rich Hodge for his support of our program. And the Athlete Amplifier. New NIL, part of the QFA system. Thanks to Joe Rinaldi for his support for Quantum Financial Advisors and the Athlete Amplifier, two of his companies. He's sponsoring this DMV LACROSSE
so Joe's,
game of the week.
Joe sponsored with Athlete Amplifier. I'm wondering if he could get me an NIL deal with an Italian restaurant, maybe.
He probably could.
Pizza joint?
Yes, Joe. Can you do that? Hit us up, Joe. He said to say hi, by the way. Sheehy Automotive. It's easy at Sheehy. Since 1996, find the Mid-Atlantic's largest selection of vehicles. A special thanks to the Fowler family for their support of our event. And the Matten Companies. Thanks to Matten Companies for their sponsorship of this game, where director James and his three sons, Joe, James, and Michael, have competed here for Gonzaga. Joe's headed off to Ohio State. James is currently at UNC. He needs to get that team on his shoulders and pick them up. And the Father McKenna Center. An anonymous donor has sponsored tonight's game on behalf of the Father McKenna Center in Washington, D.C. The Gonzaga community has a strong commitment to the McKenna Center, which serves men struggling with homelessness and families facing food insecurity. It provides a structured program supporting the mission of meeting needs, reclaiming lives, including a day shelter for homeless men and the food pantry for individuals and families in need. But it also depends on community support. So if you can, please help by volunteering your time and donating at fathermckenna.org. All right.
Inside Lacrosse is in the house tonight, Cabell. Terry Foy came by and waved to us before the game started. Good to see them here, checking out some of the better local talent and, frankly, national talent, too.
They've been doing a great job partnering with us. They've been promoting all our games of the week, including this one, putting out the live stream, and then doing articles on the game. Expect another article after this game. They did a phenomenal article after the Prep Gonzaga game. And then they did a great one on Landon after their big win over Bullis last Wednesday.
Great resource for the lacrosse community.
Yeah.
They've been doing a great job for many, many years.
We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back with you. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be back with you in about 3 minutes to rejoin for the second half. Back here, Cabal-Matics, with Matt Rienzo. Still halftime. I want to thank a few more sponsors before we get back to the action. Talk about the hit of the game. I haven't seen it. If we don't
see
it,
we saw one, but I didn't catch the number. So
if we don't get a hit of the game, then we give it to the most physical player.
That's
of
a good
the,
idea.
Of the game.
I like that.
The Cookie Batch, cookiebatch.com. If you can dream it, they can make it into a cookie. Man, you probably have a lot of dreams about cookies.
Yeah, there's all sorts of shapes and sizes that would work for me.
Give that player a cookie. Who's it going to be tonight? Also, the players to watch, the Sport Automotive players to watch. Thanks to Gibbs Fogarty from Landon Class of 2005 for his support of this event. When you're at Sport, if you tell them, beat Bullis, or probably beat Prep. He probably doesn't like Prep as much. He will probably hook you on his next new Tahoe. If you want to, those new Tahoes are sweet, those 24s.
I've got one on order. That's supposed to be coming
are
next month from Sport Automotive. Yeah.
Look at that. Love it. Supporting our sponsors. Players
it's been on back order for 8 months, Cabal.
They just can't keep up production?
Yeah.
Did you do a super custom order?
No,
or something?
No, not at all.
Sport Automotive, Chevrolet, Cadillac, and Honda. Be a Sport fan, too, and visit sportautomotive.com. And the post-game party brought to you in earnest by Surfside in Tenleytown. Best margaritas, best Mexican. And actually, one of the most underrated parts of that restaurant are the TV situation. It was phenomenal for the basketball games last week. They have excellent TV setup. Go in there and tell the bartenders, beat Landon, and you may get a free margarita from Georgetown Prep owner Bo Blair.
It's a great spot.
Yeah.
Bo's a great entrepreneur, great restaurateur. He does a great job. Getting ready to start the second half here. We're going to have a great second half.
Let's check out the top 20. We started talking about that. Let's dive deeper right now. So Landon plays Prep on Friday at Prep. That's a hard game for Landon.
That's huge.
Prep is hungry. They're upset they lost. Prep wins that. They're right back.
Yeah.
Right back in the thick of things. And then you got this
St.
game.
St. John's just beat Paul the Sixth yesterday, I believe.
Yeah, they did.
Two. So that's
a great game.
Starting to work itself out in the top 10.
And here we go. Back live action. Quick restart. Sorry for the delay on that. Let's see if Rivas can pick up where he left off. That's a rare Gonzaga win. The stats in the first half were scary in favor of Rivas. I had 11-1. Now make it 11-2. Offsides on Gonzaga. Sloppy. That's unnecessary right there. At this point in the season, you're mid-season. You shouldn't be getting those offsides.
As a coach, that's just crushing.
Especially after you get a rare win. Off the faceoffs. Michalis is now on Quinn, so they've done a couple of changes here. They keep Ciccatello on Marr. Oh, no, they're bumping back, so now they're going Matten back on. Never mind. They're staying with the same matchups on D. Here's Mangan down the alley. Kicks it back to Marr. He's got a step. Shows explosivity. Explosiveness.
I love that word, explosivity.
It should be a new word.
That's like physicality. Simple pick play.
Oh, my gosh.
Pick play causing havoc for the Gonzaga defense. Michalis got tied up. Not great communication, not great switch, and well executed by Bullis.
Bullis' goal by Jackson Tomac, the Michigan commit. That's a hat trick. I'm not going to throw my hat, but there might be some hats on the field. Unassisted off a pick on the invert. That's his third. The Michigan commit has come to play. He's having a great game. 7-5. First goal since the first quarter for Bullis. It was 4-1 after one, if you're just joining us. And then it was six straight goals for Gonzaga in the second. Quick pickup there by Rivas. Skip pass over to Anzalone with Michalis on him.
Good time right now.
Inside look. Deflected by Kane.
They had a good look. They just couldn't capitalize. They had them a little scrambled on transition defense there.
Let's see if Gonzaga can stay on sides here and clear. They have three poles back, so it should be pretty easy to stay on sides. They didn't take a pole off. Now they might. Wide open on the far side is Mikey Settles, recently committed to Notre Dame. I believe he played football, and then he played soccer here at Gonzaga, which is pretty rare for the varsity. Great D. Mitty, phenomenal student. Over to Geary in the first line. Mitty's with Robbie Bath. Geary, the South Carolina commit. Here he is, Robert
Geary
Bath.
Going on to play club at South Carolina. The club level is exploding in the United States. Quality lacrosse.
Yeah, a lot of great club programs out there, like Clemson and South Carolina and SMU, where my boys are going, and those guys take it seriously. Some of them have stadiums. Some of them have
budgets,
fully paid
real budgets
and fully paid coaches, and they let you have a life and join fraternities as well if you'd like. So you can, Geary, who's one of the best middies, just making a nice
that was
play
a
there.
Good, another good ride by Gonzaga.
Collision.
And, Bullis was playing without the stick there.
Look
on
at
that
James
turnover.
Gardner's speed. James Gardner is fast. Holy smokes. And he stuck it. James Gardner showing why he's going to Terpland to play for Coach Tillman.
Yeah, he's fast. He's athletic.
Holy cow.
Really, really good player.
Really fast.
You know, it's hard to play at Maryland. Someone say virtually impossible, but he's the kind of kid who might surprise people and get on the field there.
First fast break goal of the day, either team, and James Gardner makes it happen. Picks up a ground ball and runs 60 yards and sticks it. Third win for Bobby McCarthy. Rivas still, he's got a long way to go to catch up, but it hasn't seemed to matter. Gonzaga's winning the game. Usually if you lose the save battle and the face-off battle, you're not going to be in the lead, but they're losing both. The Bullis is dominating faceoffs, has more goalie saves, and is losing by three. Odd stat.
Yeah, it's hard to make sense of that other than Gonzaga's cashing in on their opportunities.
Here's Carter Caden. Already has a sweet goal in the first half. The Colgate commit junior inverted. Double invert again. We saw this once before. They had a nice goal on it. Now they're in the single invert. See if they kick it back behind and go back to the single. Johnny Gardner, righty shot, save Ferguson. Ferguson with eight on the day. He's having a night. Who got that?
Another like good ride.
Nice ride by Gardner. Popped someone and did a little hitting back. Nice split dodge by Caden.
Oh, by the way, we found out during the halftime break that mystery assist was by Chase Noyes.
Excellent assist. Thank you. Charlie Hornig again, right? Who gave us that text?
Yeah, he's my muse.
He's our third broadcaster. Oof, almost a hit of the game by the cookie batch here. See if you see a collision here. Oh, he's playing from out of bounds. Great play there.
It was a good play, but he was stepping out of bounds when he scooped up the ground ball.
Yeah, that was Caleb Oliver making the play there, or trying to make the play. Stevenson over to Tom Petty.
Nice check by Gaetano Cicatello on that last turnover. He put it on the ground.
Committed to Yale, phenomenal defenseman, only a junior. Here's Carey being dodged by Silberman. Kicks it back to Marr with Cicatello on him.
I'd like to see Bullis go back to a pick for Marr. I mean, it worked last time. He's the best player on their side of the field.
Looks like he's going behind to do just that. They're going to go back to him here, possibly. And nice check there by by Joe Matten forces the turnover.
Yeah, that was nice persistence, staying on the glove.
And here's Joe.
Staying active with his stick.
Joe chucks it up to Eric Carey. Eric Carey, the sophomore D-Mitty, varsity soccer player. Down to Chase Noyes, who's having a nice game tonight since being put in the second quarter on attack.
Yeah, Chase Noyes has good size, good length.
Tough situation here for Richie DeMaio. First minutes of the game, and he's got a pole all over him. Richie DeMaio, or maybe it's DeMaio, in there. Fowler with the backhand shot, backed up, fortunately, for Gonzaga by Chase Noyce. So Gonzaga going to what I guess is their third line, Matt. Showing some depth.
Yeah, that's interesting.
They do have probably the most lacrosse players in the DMV in their program, with well over 100 that come out every year. Sometimes I hear it's closer to more like 150. They still have a freshman team here?
I think it's just JV and varsity now.
Why'd they drop the freshman team? Probably couldn't get opponents, right?
During COVID, you know, you had a lot of drops.
10-man.
Interest and things like
Holy smokes. There was another 10-man ride turnover. Forced turnover. Look at his speed. Looks like Gardner. Is this Gardner? Another forced turnover. And Kane was on him. Kane was on Jackson Tomac. Kevin Kane, the goalie, junior. That was almost a cookie batch. Nice.
It was
athletic
good job
play
by number 10 on Bullis, holding up and not fouling. Up, then they do foul.
Jake Mendenhall. So the third line is getting some run here for Gonzaga.
And they drew a penalty.
Looks like Grant Stevenson might have nicked him. The game control, you can feel like they've figured out how they want to play tonight. Took them a quarter.
Geary floating around inside. See if they can find him like they did at the end of the prep game last week.
Quick slide there by Bullis. Johnny goes right by the slide. All right, and they're going to be man up here. Just a fifth man up for Gonzaga. What'd they call it? I didn't see the hand signal.
It was a slash.
They called a slash. All right.
It was a slash on number 10 for Bullis, Grant Stevenson. You know, Bullis has yet to get in a rhythm offensively.
Well, not since the first, right?
Yeah. They haven't found that rhythm here in the second half. And now they have to have a penalty kill here. It's a big stop.
Bullis wants to get back in this game. They're going to need to go rely heavy on number 21, Jackson Marr. Use a pick, whatever you got to do.
Yeah, I don't. Well, we'll talk about that when we're at the other end.
Nice play there by Rafferty, the natural lefty coming around. I believe that was Rafferty. Yes, it was. Rafferty here with the ball again. 45 seconds to go in the penalty. Fowler over to Gardner. Gardner inside to Fowler, wide open. He dropped his stick. If he had just snapped it, he wouldn't have gotten it deflected. Giving it to Bullis on that. Interesting call.
That was
I think the ref had a bad angle on that.
Yeah, that was questionable.
You and I had a very good angle
right
on that.
It was right in front of us. It's pretty much certainly Gonzaga's ball, but that's what happens.
They give it to the attackman. You probably couldn't see it on the screen. Great run out by Quinn Anzalone with Robbie Bath now on him. Quinn going right at the double team, showing some aggressiveness. Oh, he throws it away. And now Gonzaga's got a 3-on-1. Nope, two on three. I don't know where I don't know where all their attackmen are.
They were subbing, so their attackmen are over at the box.
Fowler tripped and then almost got clocked, but and then Bullis picks it up.
Let's see if Bullis can get some transition offense here. Five on three.
And he just walks up
and
shoots
it. That's not a good shot. When you're 5-on-3, you don't settle for a 15-yard shot.
Yeah,
make another pass and allow them to get a dunk instead of a 15-yarder.
Ooh! Johnny Gardner from Sam Lukowski.
And frankly, that's what happens when you take a bad shot at one end.
So the pole gets the assist. Sam Lukowski, end-to-end off the great save by Kane, his eighth unofficially on the night. That now has caught him up to Ferguson. Oh, sorry, Ferguson has 9.
So, that, you know, essentially it's a 5-on-3 for Bullis, a chance to get it to 8-6, and instead now it's 9-5.
Yeah, I don't know why Tom Petty decided to shoot that from the midline. I mean, sorry, the restraining line. That's a push. So Gonzaga gets the win there on a rare win on a faceoff, their fourth only of the night. And here comes the second line with Carter Caden, Cody Hobson, and 33, Caleb Oliver on seconds this evening. The junior. Here he is, showing good speed. Gonzaga's just got so many players.
Yeah, they've played 9 middies on offense.
Yeah, they've already played 9 middies and about 3 or 4 D middies. They're missing their best D middie in Ryan Pels, the Brown commit, and they still are doing fine with Settles and James Gardner and now Eric Carey. Just loaded with athletes at this school. Phenomenal Jesuit all-boys school. About 1,000 students with a phenomenal field. I love this field down here at Buchanan. Not easy to get to, but once you get here, it's awesome.
Flag down,
Mar,
on Gonzaga, possibly a slash.
Does Mar know that? Yeah, he does. Okay. Chance for Bullis to get and one here. Pull it to 9-6 and then get a man-up opportunity. Kind of need this. With 2:25 to go in the third quarter, they kind of need to start clawing back here quicker. Jackson Marr, Gaetano on him. Shot. Man, he snapped that off.
That's not a bad look.
Yeah.
Puts that on Cage.
And that's his off. I mean, his left is as good as his right. That's why UPenn is going to get him. He'll probably make an immediate impact up there in Philly. Bullis seems to pump kids to Penn. They got the
Well, Tyler Keel's up there.
Keel, that they have
He's
a lot
a great player and
they,
a great
I think they have 4
great
kids on the roster.
So I'm sure Gonzaga sent Declan Monahan to Penn last year. Obviously incredible school, incredible lacrosse program as well.
Oh, they're shutting off. A man down, they're shutting off Jackson Marr.
I like
Shorty.
That. I like that.
They're going box around it, and looks like Jackson's just going to settle to be out of the play.
Let's see what Balestri does here with Maher being shut off.
I always think you put him inside and set some picks.
Yeah, yeah, put him inside.
Set picks. He's just kind of no man's land here. Now he's going to go inside. Wide open. Blocked.
There's great ground ball by Gaetano Cicatella.
Gaetano, or G as they call him, 9-5.
They call him G? I didn't know that. I'm going to have to start using
that. I just heard someone call him G-Man.
All right, G-Man.
I'll just go with G. His name is a handful.
Great man down defense there by Gonzaga. Good strategy to shut off 21 for Bullis, Jackson Maher, and it worked.
I just like saying Gaetano Cicatello. I feel like
I'm glad you can pronounce it this year.
I feel Italian. I feel like I've just like had a pasta bowl after I say his name. G's a lot easier for the speed of the call, though, isn't it?
It is.
50 seconds to go here in the third. Gonzaga up 4. Jake Mendenhall on the dodge. Look at Coach King. The head coach, Jeff King, going with the thirds for the second time this quarter.
And James Gardner's on offense, too. Stayed in.
Showing some confidence in the Young Bucks. Coach King and
James Gardner, the top D middy, staying in to play offense.
Is he going off now, or is he going to
stay? No, he's right here.
There he is. Near side in their 10-man ride. I mean, they go 10-man every time to the point where the other teams don't even push, and they got attackmen standing sides on Gonzaga. It's a play-on situation here. Looks like Gardner went off, and here's Gardner playing D.
Yeah, he just tiptoed the line.
Oh.
So the flag is down,
so start
dead ball,
half.
So there will be no face-off. It'll
Correct.
Be Bullis's ball because the flag is down when the quarter expired.
End of the third quarter. That was a lower-scoring, lower-action quarter, 9-5. It was 7-4, Gonzaga, who dominated the second. Let's thank our sponsors here as we enter into the final quarter, 9-5, the Eagles here at home. The Beltway Lacrosse League, built for the best. The DMV's top 18 and over Summer Lacrosse League for men. They even have a Masters 35 and over league. I'm thinking about putting a Madlax alumni team in there.
Don't call me.
Summer league registrations opens on BeltwayLacrosse.com here shortly. And the Father McKenna Center, an anonymous donor, has sponsored tonight's game on behalf of the Father McKenna Center here. The Gonzaga community has a strong commitment to the McKenna Center here on campus, which serves men struggling with homelessness and families facing food insecurity. It also depends on your community support. So if you can, please help by volunteering your time or donating at fathermckennacenter.org. And the Quantum Financial Advisors, QFA's five-star offense maximizes client returns while their five-star defense generates additional current income while mitigating market risk. Additionally, the Athlete Amplifier, QFA's new NIL initiative, empowers student-athletes through personalized branding and sponsorship deals with local community business. Thanks to our loyal DMV supporter, co-founder, and Bullis parent, Joe Rinaldi. Learn more at QFAinc.com. We're going to start with a man up for the Bulldogs. And the Bulldogs need this. Down four, they got to start crawling back.
Yeah, if they're going to mount a real comeback here. Oh, they're offsides. They just sent someone on the field.
Gonzaga,
and they already had enough guys in.
So Gonzaga, a little sloppy here to start the fourth. Can Bullis take advantage? They need one here. Ironically, if they score, I think it gets wiped out anyways because it's just an offside. So
that's
actually a really smart play. Everyone's probably scratching their head. Why did he just throw the ball out of bounds?
Two
the reason
men
why
up.
Is because now they're going to have two men up.
For the remainder of the first penalty.
Instead of having to deal with going even there for 30 seconds. You don't see that happen very often, but a smart. Here they go, into a 3-3 set. These get so many shots, easy shots. And here's one. Bang. Jackson Marr.
Yeah, when you're two men up, you don't need to do it much fancy. Just move the ball, step in, move the ball. Good execution there by Bullis. Taking advantage, that was a critical goal for them if they're going to mount a comeback here. Down three, 9-6 with 11:27 to go in the fourth quarter.
Looks like that was assisted by...
probably Anzalone, came from that left wing.
Yeah, exactly. He was coming from X, it looks like. Yeah, it was Quinn. 9-6 here. I'm Cabo Maddox here, just starting the fourth quarter with Matt Rienzo, expert analysis on the mic. And look at McCarthy. McCarthy getting a clean win, one of his only ones of the evening. He does have five wins, but that was his most pure pinch and pop by far. It was ugly early in that Revis one. I think 11-1. Now it's 11-5. Gonzaga with the ball. Over to Geary. First line middies. Haven't been out in a while. They ran three. They went 1-2-3. Now they're back to the ones.
Well, these guys should be fresh. I'd like to see Bath get involved.
He has one on the evening on a man up. Invert. They'd like this invert set. They've used it. They're listening to you.
Yep. I mean, it's tough to defend.
This could be the hit. This could be the hit. Nope.
Incredible
nice
agility to keep the ball amidst a somersault.
Devin Geary. What a good athlete. Headed to South Carolina. Johnny Gardner. And that's backed up by the goalie. Good hustle there by Braden Ferguson, the Syracuse commit, in the goal for Bullis. And now he's 10-man ride right into it. I mean, look at Gonzaga pop into that 10-man like it's nothing. They're really good at that. But, wow, Bullis.
They couldn't fully get into it that time. They were a little bit – the attack was down on the ball instead of deep. They really like that full field ride when they pull the attack deep towards the midfield
line. It's like
line.
A softer 10-man.
Yeah, it works.
Heck, yeah. That's what they're known for. It's one of the keys to the game. But last year was concerned. Here's Marr. Gets back to his right. It's a problem. Yeah, he is looking very explosive this evening.
Yeah, he's impressive. And that was just him willing it to happen. Dodged through a couple guys. He's just faster and more athletic.
That's his third. Another hat trick.
Yeah, he ran through a couple stick checks there. And, you know, you're going to have to body him up, and then you're going to have to double with body as well. Stick checks aren't going to work on an athlete and a player like Jackson Maher.
9-7 now. Jackson Maher scoring the last two. That's his third, and he has 4 points with an assist on the evening. Revis is batting the ball around nicely. Good pickup by Revis, his 12th win of the evening. It could be the cookie batch hit of the game. No call by Joe Matten. Give Joe Matten a cookie.
I'm going to watch the replay. We might have our awardee of hit of the game.
And then Gardner gets taken down, and they're calling in the crease.
That was Irasari on the hit.
It was Irasari. Alex Irasari just dropped him. And then Johnny Gardner gets just crushed going to the goal, and they don't call any slashes. In fact, they call Johnny in the crease. Tough call there for Gonzaga.
Crowd getting very spirited.
Yeah, I mean, I thought they have a good point. Looked like Gardner got slashed and pushed, and then you hate it as an attackman, you get called in the crease. 8:53 this young man right here going to UPenn is making a game of it, and he's now put the team on his shoulders.
Well, we said that, didn't we? Like, if they're going to mount a comeback, he needs to become what we know he can be, and he's certainly showing out now.
Absolute cannon.
And that was a mismatch. I mean, he had a younger, much smaller defender on him, and no double came. They need to double and support pretty much whoever's guarding him. I mean, I know that they have guys that can guard him, Ciccatello, Matt, and others, but you still want to double. Take the pressure off those defenders. Double that player. Force someone else to win the game for them.
Look at, they're going hardcore, which is two push-up. Picked up quickly by Fowler. Fowler cross-checked. No call. Hold in the slash. And they still don't call it. I mean, he's getting murdered.
That was incredible. That was a foul 100%. He was wrapped around his neck with a hold and no call. And now it's 9-8 with 8 minutes to go.
He got murdered and they didn't call it. This game is ramped up in intensity. This could be a collision.
I love
here.
It.
He settles back on D. Man, that was some good action right there. Good hit by Alex Irasari, the leading candidate right now for the cookie batch.
He's the only candidate.
Hit in the game. There's been a couple of hits, I just realized earlier, after Johnny Gardner shoots it, he gets picked up by Kane.
The good hit by Michael Michalis there as well.
Michalis,
on
the
shooter.
Now the hits are coming. Another nomination there. Great hit by
what a pass. That was like an 80-yard pass by Joe Matten to James Gardner.
Wow.
I didn't think that had a chance in hell of getting there, but it connects perfectly. Well
done. Why
didn't
he throw it? They weren't a 10-man ride.
He just saw an opening and took it. Wasn't much of an opening, I'll tell you that much.
Maybe we can get a crowd shot of the Gonzaga guys now taking off their shirts. You know it's serious when the Gonzaga students are taking their shirts off in the middle of the game.
It's a fourth quarter shirts off routine.
Yeah, here we go. 7 minutes to go, 9-8 Gonzaga. Here's Carter Caden. Kicks it off to Fowler. Fowler inside to Cody. Can't handle it. This could be some physicality right here.
I don't know if he was handcuffed or if he was checked or what, but.
Picked up by Carter Caden. Gets his own rebound.
It's a good time to go to the goal.
Kicks it out to Gardner. Gardner's going to scoop it up. Has Blake Paris on him. Gets a step on Blake. Overhand shot. Down corner goal. Oh.
Number three versus number three, Johnny Gardner, guarded by Blake Paris, and Johnny Gardner for Gonzaga gets the better of him on that particular matchup. It's been a good matchup all day. I think Blake's done well on Johnny, although he does have a few goals.
10-8 here, 6:32 to go, plenty of time. This game has ratcheted up in intensity. Another win by Revis and company. Bullis, 13-5 in the... And I've missed a couple there because it should be, I believe, 20 faceoffs, not
it's all right.
18. But, you know, we're doing our best here.
We got 10-8 Gonzaga leads with 6 minutes to go in the fourth quarter down here on I Street. And Bullis with the ball. Bullis look for Jackson Maher right here.
Let's see if they pick for him. He's just going to take a split on G. Gets his right hand. Nothing. Kicks it out nicely to Quinn Anzalone. Big save by Kane. Kane needed that one.
I didn't love that offensive look. I didn't love that. He dodged into a lot of traffic. Threw it on the perimeter for a long shot. Didn't love that possession by Bullis.
Bullis in a regular ride here. They don't go 10-man, but they do pressure the heck out of you. Kitano has Bath open. No, Bath now guarded. Good rotation there by Bullis on the ride. Gee, has to run it out himself because he can't see anyone. I don't know if they call a timeout this early, and they do.
Well, they got one more after this. Yeah. Nice play there by number 72, Jake Gullerson. Probably didn't notice it on the screen, but he ran back across the midfield line in time for Cicatello to come up the field.
From the DMV. And the MVP, it's time to start thinking about our MVP awards right now, sponsored by that DMV LACROSSE Showcase. We will announce that right after the game. If you want to get involved and sponsor this game or any of the future games of the week, be sure to email us at dmvlax@madlax.com. We have sponsorship packages. We have features like the hit of the game that Cookie Batch has done. We have MVP sponsorships, a lot of opportunities. Great way and a fun way to get involved for your business or your family to support the greatest lacrosse area in the country, the DMV. All right, back at the action here. Big, big moment here for Gonzaga. I feel like if they can get a lead out to three, then it's going to be tough on Bullis. Bullis is, and Jackson Marr has put the team on his back. Bullis coming out in man-to-man, like in a shot clock, 5 minutes in the game.
I like this 1-4-1 set. It gives him a lot of space to maneuver.
Nice pick there for Gardner by Robbie Bath. Johnny Gardner gets underhand. Huge save by Braden Ferguson. And, man, did Bullis need that. And looks like they have a little bit of transition here.
I'd like to see early offense here by Bullis. I'd like to see them go to the goal. Right now.
Braden's 10th on the night.
You know, it's one of those things where you have extra defenders in there sometimes, but I love going to the goal, especially end of the – it's the fourth quarter, 5 minutes to go. Look for that early offense. Try and get something going quickly.
And here's the man who's put the team on his back, Jackson Marr. You can tell he's just explosive tonight.
I'd love
man.
To see them give
Great
him a
look
pick.
Inside. What a pass. If he starts doing that, then you're in trouble because right when you're like, okay, we got to slide on this guy.
Really nice feed by down Jackson Maher.
Yeah, down to 15. It's Marr. It down to 15.
Marr.
It looks like Mayer, like the singer, actor. But it's not. It's Marr, and he is having a game.
He's outstanding.
Tom Petty.
Really impressive.
Tom Petty on the goal there off that sick feed. And we have a 10-9 game here with 4:26. Could it be as...
Could it go to overtime like last year? Gonzaga winning an OT thriller last year.
And like our game 2 weeks ago, these games of the week, we try to pick the best teams and the best matchups. Nice ride there by young buck, Jake Gullerson.
Yeah, he batted down that pass.
This is a big GB here for Bullis, and they get it. 60 seconds on the shot clock, plenty of time. Look who's open. Look who's got the ball in transition there. Cicatello's got his hands full with this monster.
Table is set for a great finish here.
Yeah, this is what we love. Hopefully you're enjoying this at home as much as we are down here on the field. Great venue here at Buchanan Field at Gonzaga College High School. We're inches away from the field, which makes me feel like we're part of it. Here's Jackson Marr. Will it be his sixth point of the evening? Shot wide. 24 seconds to go.
Single invert for
Bullis.
Here's
Ike Silberman being guarded by James Garter. Two big time players. Big save by Kane on the overhand shot.
Yeah, he hugged the near pipe quite well.
By 27, Avi Ruiz taking that shot. They must have been getting some other players in for Bullis.
27,
you're right. It's Avi Ruiz who just took that shot. So Bullis showing a little depth here, especially with 3 minutes to go in the game, down. And another save by Kane. So he has 10 on the night. Great game by Kevin Kane.
Kevin Kane's really doing a nice job. Was a little shaky in the beginning of the year, but he's really done well the last couple games that I've seen.
For sure. It kind of started at the prep game, didn't it? Gonzaga trying to ice the game here with 2:20. as a coach here, you probably want to take most of the shot clock and then you want to score, because a two-goal lead changes your strategy in the last 2 minutes of a game immensely.
Yeah, they're going to want to go to the goal now.
I mean, the ref purposely no call. I kind of like the no call, but that was a violent slash to the head.
Yeah, he doesn't seem to be interested in calling much.
He looked at it and literally said, you know what, I'm not going to affect the game. 2:10 to go here. 10-9, Eagles. Johnny Gardner, no slide in the picture. Now the slides are coming. Johnny should pass this. He gets inside, and he gets popped.
So Johnny Gardner with a phenomenal game-changing play. I mean, that's massive for Gonzaga.
That's his sixth goal tonight. He's having a game. Like, we thought Jackson Maher was having a game. That is incredible. He's got a double hat trick. 2 minutes exactly, 11-9 Eagles. I'm Cabo Maddox here with Matt Rienzo. Buckle in for the last 2 minutes. It's a push with possession.
Oh, they threw
Gonzaga.
A flag.
That could be, that is, they're going to be able to milk a full 30 off the clock on that. And then some. That's a bad penalty for Bullis if they were going to get back in the game. What a huge win for Bobby McCarthy on the faceoff. Phenomenal win. He wins the ones that matter in the fourth quarter.
I think in this situation, I just kill the clock. I kill all 80 seconds.
For sure.
I just don't even take a shot extra, man. And I just bring that clock down to, my math is not very good, but around 35 seconds.
Yep. So
and then
60,
from there,
80, 20, 25 seconds.
You know, you just have to play defense and not give up two goals in 35 seconds.
Yeah, there's a minute 55 in the game, 80 on the shot clock. And like, recommended they hold the ball and look it. Fowler's going to – he probably heard you. They're just going to stand. Bullis has got to come out and start pressuring. Now, this is high risk for Bullis. Your man down and pressuring. As Gonzaga, if you
Yeah,
if
but you,
you
don't want to be out chasing around man down. That's recipe for disaster.
But you're down two. You got to go. So they're going to start coming. Here they come.
A little bit of pressure's all right, but if they extend out, there's going to be someone wide open.
Ryder Hannon.
Just like that.
They forced a pass into McNamara.
And there was another guy open on the backside. Geary was open on the backside. It's just hard to chase guys around when you're man down.
Bullis calls timeout on the dead ball. Timeout Bullis. 1:21 to go. We'll keep it here. Thanks for joining us on the – someone's got a whistle louder than mine over there. Thanks for joining us here at the DMVLAX Game of the Week. It's been a special – treat here. Let's start talking about it. It's actually not very difficult to pick the DMVLAX Showcase MVPs. It's either going to be double hat trick if they hold on to win.
Assuming Gonzaga wins this game, which it's looking like they will with only a minute 20 to go, up by two. You never know what could happen, but assuming they do, Johnny Gardner gets my vote. Incredible game.
Let's see what they can do for the last.
If somehow Bullis is able to pull this off, Jackson Maher might get the nod here.
Let's see what they can do here for the last few minutes. 1 minute and 23 seconds to go in the game. Gonzaga with the ball. Bullis is in a total shutout, and their goalie shut off, and their goalie is out of the goal too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
So there.
Wait. Bullis has too many guys.
Yeah, they have seven guys on the field.
Bullis has too many guys, and the referees did not see it.
And the Gonzaga coaches haven't called it either. Unless the penalty. I don't know how the penalty could have expired.
Well, they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 guys on defense still.
They were man down before the timeout, weren't they?
And they had their goalie standing up here, which is an old school move. I love that move. Missed. Big hit there by Grant Stevenson, but then they're still going to go man down again because of the slash to the helmet on one of the defenders for Bullis, who slashed Johnny Gardner on the face, and Johnny sold it nicely with 49 seconds to go. Bullis, you see what they did there? The penalty must have been expired.
Yeah, the penalty expired. Must have been a 30-second.
That's what happened. Bullis had their goalie on attack and had seven players down, which is allowed. You still have to have four short six, but they had four right. Throws a back pass to McNamara. Makes a nice play. They got players up top. He doesn't see him. There, now he sees them. There's James Gardner, one of the fastest guys on the field. They put him out here on penalty kill. You always want to put your fast guys on the field to penalty kill.
Absolutely, and then he's also a great D-middy. So if you turn it over, you got your better defensive midfielder in the game.
And they got Mr. Clutch out there, Robbie Bath. MVP of the last game with Fowler. 16 seconds to go. It's going to be an Eagles win. 11-9. So high. Tossed it. And they're going to win 11-9. And they're starting to sing here, student section, the Gonzaga fight song.
Hard-fought game by both teams. Fantastic. Really impressed with the fight of Bullis here at the end in the fourth quarter to claw back and make it an exciting finish. But Gonzaga was just too much. Too much depth, too much athleticism, and frankly, really good execution. But a well-fought game by both teams and another great DMV matchup.
Yeah, we'll give the cookie batch hit of the game. Are we going to give that to Irasari or are we going to give it to
Michalis?
Michalis on that big monster hit, the hammer. Michael Michalis awarded the cookie. Give that player a cookie, the hit of the game presented by the Cookie Batch at thecookiebatch.com. Gardner stepped up and played big time. He had a double hat trick. Let's see if he had any assists. He had a double hat trick, 6-0 on the night. A phenomenal game for the Maryland commit as he leads Gonzaga number two to stay locked at that number two spot in the DMV rankings.
And they might get some help from Georgetown Prep on Friday if they can pull off a win against Landon. Gonzaga would move up to number one.
Yeah, Gonzaga would bump to one, and that's right before the Gonzaga-Landon game the following week. So Friday's game is huge. I want to thank our sponsors, Beltway Lacrosse League, QFA, Quantum Financial Advisors, the Athlete Amplifier, the Matten Companies, Sheehy Auto Stores, and the Father McKenna Center. We're going to show you the celebration here. Tell them to there's the celebration here. I'm Cabo Maddox here with Matt. Thank you very much for joining me once again as you look onto Gonzaga celebrating with their classmates, their teammates, and good friends here on I Street on Buchanan Field.
A great result, but a really well-played game on both sides.
And here's Gonzaga singing their fight song as we sign off. Thanks for joining us with DMVLAX Game of the Week. I'm Cabo Maddox for Matt Rienzo. Have a great rest of your week. They're just